Maxima and minima word problems, guaranteed 6 marker in your board exams. Let's do it together in 5 simple steps. Trust me, if you watch this video till the end, you will be able to crack any word problem in the topic. Are you excited? Let's get started. So now, as I run you through the 5 steps, I would request you people to either start noting it down simultaneously, or maybe you can pause the video and take a screenshot in the end. It's very, very important. So these are the very simple 5 steps which would make your word problems damn easy. Look at the first one. It says always introduce your question. By this we mean draw a figure if required. Mention the given to prove. Now, howsoever obvious it may sound, trust me, it is one tool which is going to make your life very simple. So, and make sure whatever is given in the question, any specific quantity that is given in the question, is treated as a constant. Now, for to prove, you are going to actually mention the 2 things. First, mostly in such questions, you either have to prove a certain condition or you have to find a certain unknown quantity. So list that, what you have to do. Secondly, and the most important thing, list down whatever quantity has to be maximized or minimized here. Now, moving on to step 2, the kickstart formula. By this we mean begin with the formula for what is to be maximized or minimized. So if you have maximized or minimized quantity clearly laid out in step 1, then this becomes almost mechanical. You just pick up the formula for that specific thing and start writing. Step 3. Ensure that the formula is in terms of only one variable. You know you have been differentiating only with respect to one variable at this level. So you have to be very, very sure that the formula which you have written is actually catering to only one variable. If not, then you would refer to the given condition and convert it in terms of one variable. Step number 4, find or prove. So this is the part which we are now trying to find. What we are going to do for this is, once you have converted the above formula in terms of only one variable, differentiate it and put it equal to 0. The moment you do that, just like your critical points, you solve and you reach your answer, whatever has to be proved or found. Finally, and most of the students just forget about this step because you're so happy the moment you reach what you had to find that you just end up skipping. But then it has 1 mark in the paper, so don't do that. So step 5 says confirm for maxima or minima. By this I mean apply your second derivative test, substitute the quantity and see, is the second derivative turning out to be greater than 0 or less than 0? Whatever is the situation, that will confirm that yes, your answer is correct and you have indeed minimized or maximized the quantity which you had to do in the beginning. Trust me, if you know these 5 steps, the question becomes so mechanical to handle. I cannot wait to share a question with you which will follow these 5 steps. Let's see that. Let's look at the question. It says, show that height of the right circular cone of maximum volume that can be inscribed in a sphere of radius small r is 4r by 3. Also show that the maximum volume of the cone is 8 by 27 times the volume of the sphere. So let's now filter all this and introduce your question. So as a part of step 1, I've already drawn the figure and then I've introduced my question. So given radius of the sphere small r. So now whatever is given is to be treated like a constant in the question. Now I'm introducing certain variables and we must mention that in the very beginning. So small h be the height of the cone, capital R be the radius of the cone. Now don't mix the two R's. This one is a constant and this is a variable because we are introducing it. And let capital V be the volume of the cone. Now to prove, first of all you have to show that the height is 4R by 3, then volume of the cone is 8 by 27 times volume of the sphere, and most importantly, your volume of the cone is to be maximized. So step number 2 is the kickstart formula. Begin with the formula of what has to be maximized or minimized. Like here, volume of the cone has to be maximized. So you know the formula, 1 by 3 pi capital R square into h. Now, having done that, step 3, ensure that your formula is only in terms of one variable. Now here, capital R and h, both of them are the variables which you have introduced. So there are two variables. Now how do I convert it into one? Use your given information. Now please see, while you use your given information, that is small r, look at this small triangle and use one of the most powerful tools in math, which is Pythagoras theorem. So now I know dA. Now the entire AC is your height. This is small r, so of course AD becomes h minus r. So in triangle DAB, you'll have h minus r whole square plus capital R square is equal to small r square. Let's simplify. Now of course, you have two choices. Either write h in terms of capital R or vice versa. Now, r square is much easy to put in this. So your volume of the cone becomes 1 by 3 pi. In place of r square, I put 2rh minus h square into h. And now, as a part of your step 3, your volume has been converted in terms of only one variable. Why one variable? Because if you remember, small r is just a constant. So the only variable is h. Now, step number 4, differentiate and put it equal to 0 so that we can handle these two proving things. Let's see how we do that. So first of all, if we differentiate with respect to h, you get pi by 3 is just a constant. This gives us 4rh minus 3h square. Now for maxima or minima, put dv by dh equal to 0. So this would give us 4rh is equal to 3h square, that is h is equal to 4r by 3. We have proved successfully one of the conditions. Next is you have to prove that volume of the cone is equal to volume of the sphere. I hope you all remember what is the volume of the sphere. It is 4 by 3 pi r cube. So we have to prove this volume is equal to this. Let's see how we do it. So once we have found small h, your capital R square would be 2r into h minus h square. That's what we have, which on simplifying gives us 8r square by 9. Now let's substitute the values of h and r square in volume. So we get volume is equal to 1 by 3 pi. R square is 8r square by 9 and h is 4r by 3. So now let's see, we are anyway interested in 8 by 27, which we take it out. And now after taking that out, what are we left with? We are left with 4 pi r cube by 3. So we proved that volume of the cone is 8 by 27 times volume of the sphere. Wasn't this simple? But wait, this is not the end of the question. Don't forget your step 5, which was to double differentiate and ensure that yes, the volume is indeed getting maximized. So step number 5, let's double differentiate this. D square V by dh square would be pi by 3, and here it becomes just 4r minus 6h. Now we are going to substitute for the value of your small h here. So we get d square v by dh square at h equal to 4r by 3 becomes pi by 3 4r minus 6 into 4r by 3. Let's simplify this. So you see, you get a negative sign, less than 0. This means volume of the cone is maximized. So, if you now go through the entire question, in those 5 simple steps, we've summed up everything without missing out on any detail, and 6 marks are yours. Please have a look. I hope this video will help you in solving any word problem. Please come back with your feedback in the comment section below. Also, if you found the video useful, give it a big thumbs up and do not forget to share it with your friends. It will help everyone. And if you haven't done that so far, make sure to subscribe to my channel. It's absolutely free. See you with the next one. Until then, bye-bye.